Hey guys, what is going on? It's Don here from Nova Spirit Tech working with Micro Center, and today I got an exciting episode for you guys. We're going to be checking out the BYO section, also announcing a new initiative that they're doing, and also picking up a Ryzen third generation, and we're going to benchmark it. So let's check it out. This is a huge computer and electronics store. They basically have everything from laptops to printers to everything that you could think of. And most of the products are on display, so you know what you're buying and you could feel everything. That's one of my favorite things about this store. But that's not why we're here today. Today, I am gonna show you guys the BYO. So let's check that out right now. All right, so this is a BYO section. They basically have everything from cases to CPUs to memory, everything that you need. But be sure when you do come to a Micro Center, talk to a sales representative because they work here, so they know the best deals that are around. So you might be coming in with an intention of a certain build, but depending on what deals you're getting, you might switch up your build. So definitely talk to a sales representative and they'll be able to get whatever you need. So they also have this new program where you can have Micro Center build the computer for you. So you can pick out all the parts that you need and just have them build it. So if you're intimidated by building computers, or either you need a whole series of them, like 5 or 6 of them, you could have them build it. You just need to talk to one of the sales representatives here and they can make it happen. All right, so finally we got the Ryzen third generation on hand. So let's go back to the studio to check it out. So welcome back to the studio. And what we have here is the Ryzen third generation 3700X, Samsung SSD 970 Evo Plus, and 3 different brands of motherboards with the x570 chipset. The reason why I chose a 3700X is I believe this is more of a people's choice, you could say. This is the best value of the CPUs out of their entire lineup, I believe, at a TDP of 65 watts, base clock of 3.6, turbo boost up to 4.4, and it's the new third generation. Now, why I also have the Samsung Evo, it's because one of the main features of this is PCIe 4.0, which will increase all PCIe lanes. As of right now, the SSD is the only thing we could test on the PCIe 4.0 because I believe the Navi is the only graphic card that supports the PCIe 4.0, which we don't have, so we can't test as of yet. Now these new boards, it's not just a change of chipset. Everything changes in here, including the PCIe 4.0. You got the new USB, which could go up to 10 gigabits, and the Ethernet ports on each one of these things are 2.5 gigabits instead of 1 gigabit that you're used to. More on these boards a little bit later, but first I want to do my base test, which I'm more excited about than any of these, which is backwards compatibility with the CPU. Now, I've been running a 1700 for about 3 years now, and that's my main desktop go-to PC, my daily driver basically, which is also the direct predecessor to this guy, because they both run at 65 watts. Now, the 1700 is only 3.0 base gigahertz and 3.7 boost. So just from that alone, the CPU is automatically faster just from the base clocks. So we're mainly gonna be testing the CPU using Cinebench, PC Mark, and also testing the SSD speeds with Crystal Disk. Each of these motherboard tests will be using this Evo, as well as 16 gigabytes of Ballistics 3600 megahertz RAM. Dual channel. So if your plans are just upgrading the CPU without having to buy the newer motherboards, we're going to be able to see the results here to see how much of an improvement you're going to be getting. Now be sure to check with the manufacturer to see if there is a new BIOS update so you can support the new CPU. And I also have a video, I'll link it in the description below, on how to upgrade your BIOS. But for now, let's see the results on the 1700. So the base scores on the 1700 on the B350 is 3129, which isn't too bad for a 3-year-old CPU. And the Crystal Disk benchmark is 2962 and a write speed of 1554, which I don't think is too bad on NVMe as well. Now, I didn't do a PC Mark on this test because I have this computer's been running for the past 3 years, so I have a lot of programs that run in the background that will affect the scores. So I decided to opt out against that. So now we're going to be testing the new CPU on the B350. And the results for that is astounding. Look at this, it's 4809, which is almost a 50% increase in speed just from swapping out the CPU on using an older motherboard. As far as Crystal Disk, it's a little bit faster in read at 3044, and the write's a little bit slower at 1449. So it's not too bad. I mean, it's not using the new PCIe lanes to read the SSDs because the motherboard doesn't support it, but it's still not that bad. So let's get into testing the new boards, new SSD with the new chip. All right, so the first thing I gotta say, I'm really a big fan of ASUS products. I like their software that they use behind everything, and I just like the branding Republic of Gamers. Now, on this board itself, they all come with Wi-Fi. They all have the new 2.5 gigabit Ethernet, and they all have the USB 3.2 and USB-C connectors. Now, on the ASUS-specific board, this one only has two M.2 connectors, but it still offers a lot of SATA slots, as well as a ton of USB ports in the back. 11 USB ports and one USB Type-C with two Ethernets, to be exact. Each one of these motherboards require active cooling, so you will see a fan on the back of the motherboards, and they do turn off when it's not needed, so you'll hear a fan spin up or shut down as it's needed. So here are the results for the ASUS Hero. And you can see the CPU for Cinebench is 4880. Now here is where it changes. The crystal disk. Look at the speed on this. It's 3563 on read. And the most impressive, 3327 on the write. That's double of what we were getting on our old B350 motherboards as far as SSD read and writes. It's so impressive. And I did a PC mark on this, which is 6211. And all of these, the only setting I changed was the RAM setting because we're running on 3600 megahertz, and that's the only thing I changed. I didn't fine-tune anything. I just set it up so it would be same across all three motherboards, just the RAM speed is changed. So the next up we have is the Gigabyte. You're going to notice that there's less connections on the back, so there's only 9 USBs and one USB Type-C. The heat sinks are not as dramatic. Like, they do have a fan, but it's not connected to everything. It's on its own, but they do have heat sinks on top of the M.2s. And this one has 3 M.2 connectors, along with 6 SATA ports. I feel that this one to be the most sturdiest because the bottom actually has a complete metal board, which also acts like a heatsink. It's actually connected through thermal pads to the underside of the connectors, which none of the other motherboards have. And the results for this, for Cinebench, it's 4747, which is slightly slower than the ASUS. The crystal disk mark at 3570, and the write speed at 3332, which is a hair faster than the ASUS. And then the PC mark score at 6349, which is also a hair faster than the ASUS. Yeah, but one thing I do gotta say about this board is that because the other boards actually use this active fan to kind of cool off the M.2s and all the other components, this one is the only one that's kind of separated and only cools the chipset off itself. And for our last board, this is the MSI Ace. Now this has the least amount of back connection ports, which is only 7 USB and one USB-C. Still has a 2.5 gigabit along with the other ones. But as you can see, look at this. This has the heat sink that kind of blows through all the SD cards and everything. And so it cools off the chipset and kind of travels within that. Then you have this huge coolant pipe that runs along the board to also bring it back over to where this fan is to help cool off as well. So you can see the build quality in this. On this board, there also is like a little flip switch that allows you to quick overclock, which is pretty impressive. I didn't see the other boards having that. And this also has 3 M.2 slots. So the results for this guy is very impressive. The Cinebench scores is 4958. And the read and write, you can see it's about 3,400 and change. And as far as PC mark, we're getting a 6577. So out of the three boards, MSI seems to be the fastest, which is very impressive. Maybe it's the way it cools off everything. I don't know. This also does have the least amount of SATA connectors. So if you are worried about connecting SATA drives, you only have 4 instead of the 6 compared to the other two. So there we have it. As far as my conclusion goes, if you are trying to save a buck or two, you possibly can because the older motherboards will support the new CPUs and you are definitely getting that speed benefit, but you won't be using the newer technology of the PCIe 4.0. where it will deliver faster read and write speeds and the better graphic card speeds. But if you're trying to slowly upgrade, you could just buy the CPU, upgrade now, and then upgrade the motherboard later along the line. As far as testing these three boards go, the MSI is the fastest out of the three, a gigabit being the slowest, then ASUS like right in the middle ground. What I've noticed is that the MSI fan curves are a little bit higher, that I could hear the fan more noticeably. The ASUS to be the quietest, using their software obviously for without auto-tune. ASUS has the quietest operation run. I feel that the ASUS has a better built board. But again, with the two M.2, not the three M.2 connectors, I'm kind of shaded away from that because you can't get any more M.2 connectors on the board. You have to buy an extra PCIe just to use that feature if you need to add more NVMe to hard drives. So having three versus two, I would prefer the three. And in my lineup of build quality, I feel that MSI Ace has a little bit better build quality than the Gigabyte. And I feel that they are taking advantage of this built on fan to keep the entire motherboard cool. So I like what they did on this board, as well as this little, you know, quick overclock connector selector thing. So that's my thoughts about it. If it was me, I would be getting the 3700X with the MSI motherboard. And if I can't afford the MSI motherboard, I would just keep with my motherboard that I have. So I hope you guys enjoyed that video. If you did, please hit that like button. If you guys got any questions about this, hit up in the comments below. Be sure to check out your local Micro Center and online for deals on this new CPU. And also, check out my next video where I actually take three M.2s on this X570 and do a raid on it. Let's see if we could break any records. So if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and also hitting that bell notification icon so you know when the next video is going to be out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.